a lesson from the Apocrypha, the wisdom of Sirach. Now will I recall God's work. What I have seen, I will describe. By the Lord's words, his works were brought into being. He accepts the one who does his will. As the shining sun is clear to all, so the glory of the Lord fills all his works. Yet even God's holy ones must fail in recounting the wonders of the Lord. Through God has given his host the strength to stand firm before his glory. He searches out the abyss and penetrates the heart. Their secrets he understands, for the Most High possesses all knowledge and sees from the old the things that are to come. He makes known the past and the future and reveals the deepest secrets. He lacks no understanding, no single thing escapes him. He regulates the mighty deeds of his wisdom. He is from all eternity one and the same. With nothing added, nothing taken away, no need of a counselor for him. How beautiful are all his works, delightful to gaze upon and a joy to behold. Here ends the lesson.
Rejoice in God, my Savior.
a lesson from Paul's letter to the Ephesians. For this reason, I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth takes its name. I pray that according to the riches of his glory, he may grant that you may be strengthened in your inner being with power through his Spirit, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, as you are being rooted and grounded in love. I pray that you may have the power to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who by the power at the work within us is able to accomplish abundantly far more than all we can ask or imagine, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus to all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Here ends the lesson.
Crucified by the Mary, he descended to the dead. sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray.
Thank you.
Please join in the general thanksgiving. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen.
Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth and in the age to come, life everlasting.
Thank you. Well, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to St. Paul's Episcopal Church. My name is Paul Clemmy. I'm the director of music and organist here at the parish, and I'm happy to say that now we have passed 25 years of presenting concerts as a part of the Evensong concert series and the Music Guild, who have been supporters. So it's a 25th anniversary, and I think you should all clap for yourselves. The mission of this Music Guild and also the Evensong concert series is to bring high quality music to our community and to pair it with the service of Evensong. So those of you who were able to be with us at 4 o'clock, this is part of the hourly prayer duty that dates all the way back to the beginning of the monastic period. The Anglican Church has kept this as a part of their rota. It's in our prayer book, and I'm so glad that we're able to preserve this tradition. And if you ever get a chance to go to the United Kingdom, you can expect to see and hear Evensong every day at all of the major cathedrals. So I invite you to become a supporter of the St. Paul's Music Guild. The list of supporters are in your program, and if you're brand new to us, I hope that you will consider becoming a member of the St. Paul's Music Guild. There are no meetings. All I ask is that you write a check. And I'm joking a little bit, but actually I'm not. The only way that we can support this series is through your contributions. There is no money that comes from the general budget of St. Paul's. It's because of people like you, people on the list, who have stepped forward. With that said, I want to make it very clear to all of us that these concerts are open to anyone, and there's no expectation that anyone has to pay because of the Music Guild. So please spread the word. If you're new to us today and you would like to know more about the concerts that are happening this season, there are brochures out in the narthex. So I'm very, very pleased to welcome the Big Horn Brass. Those of you who know me, I absolutely love brass instruments, and I especially love brass with organ. Now, today, I've decided to take a break, and I will not be playing the organ because this group is just fine without me. So I'm so pleased that we can have this ensemble. They've been around for a long time, based in Portland, and I love the fact that they can be here. If you can't see them all that well, I'm going to ask them to hold up their horns if they would. So with the French horns, would you hold up your horns so we can see clearly where you are? And the trumpets, I've decided to hide the trumpets a little bit, but you'll hear them just fine. Would you please hold up your instruments? There's our trumpets. And then the trombones are right behind me, and the tuba player, would you hold up your instruments? And of course, this ensemble and the music that's being played would not be complete without our two percussionists. So would you recognize our percussionists? Okay. So I'm so pleased that we can offer this concert. I hope that you'll come back. And would you please give a welcome to the Big Horn Brass?
Thank you. pardon me.
I think it's on.
It is on now, correct. Thank you. I will just have some very brief remarks this evening, but I will certainly say on behalf of the Bighorn Brass and our founder, Andrew Harris, please stand up, Andrew. Thank you. We are approaching our 40th anniversary, so 25th anniversary, I believe, of your Evensong musical presentations, and we're very happy to be part of that. And we will be celebrating our 40th anniversary in our upcoming holiday performance at the Reeser Center in Beaverton, very early December of this year. I just want to say that the next two pieces are from the first suite of Respighi's Ancient Airs and Dances, and actually the order of the two is reversed. We'll be beginning with the balletto, which is the first movement of the first suite, written in 1917 by Respighi, and then the Gagliarda will be second. So these two movements will be reversed from what's in your program. This is a marvelous arrangement by Phil Snedeker for brass and percussion of two movements of the first suite, Ancient Airs and Dances by Ottorino Respighi.
Thank you.
It's hard to believe now, but for several centuries, Monteverdi was kind of a lost composer in terms of the wider recognition, and particularly when he was so important in both the realms of sacred music, which we're representing that this evening by playing this introduction to his Vespers for the Blessed Virgin Mary. He also was extremely important in dramatic music for the stage. His opera L'Orfeo, composed roughly the same time here, is the oldest opera which has really made its way into the operatic canon and is still performed today. So we hope you enjoy this music of Claudio Monteverdi. Gabriel Fauré's Pavane, one of the most well-recognized popular pieces of classical music from the Romantic era. It's hard to imagine, actually, it was originally composed for piano, but is most well-known in Fauré's own version for orchestra with optional chorus. We feel that this arrangement for brass really does the piece justice as well. So, Gabriel Fauré's Pavane.
Thank you.
I very much appreciate Paul's acknowledgement of all the various sections of the group, and I would like to just take a quick second at this point to recognize the folks. Let's have you know the complete trumpet section. I'll ask them to stand individually and then remain standing with our section. We have on this end Scott Winks, Greg Garrett, Bruce Dunn, and Paul Mazzio, our trumpet section. Our horn section, once again left to right, Rebecca Schaub, Rebecca Ollison, Larry Johnson, and Dan Partridge, French horn. There's a friend. Our percussion section on timpani, Jennifer Rittenberg, and on miscellaneous percussion, Greg Van Winkle, our percussionist. Our low brass, starting with the lowest, bass tuba, Mark Varenkamp. On bass and contrabass trombone, John Onstead. And on tenor trombones, John Wharton and Ron Babcock. And once again, our leader on euphonium and tenor trombone, Andrew Harris. Our low brass section. Thank you very much. Well, the next couple pieces bring us into high drama, music from opera, very dramatic operas, which is probably kind of a redundancy. Most operas are dramatic. But from Samson and Delilah, the masterpiece by Camille Saint-Saëns, we have the very familiar, exciting, thrilling to play and listen to both Danse Bacchanal. Thank you. moving ahead chronologically about 50 years, this was Giacomo Puccini's final opera, which was left unfinished at his death in 1924 and was completed by a composer named Alfano. This very famous aria for tenor is in the third act, and you'll all recognize this very popular encore, which transcribes very well for brass. Nessun Dorma by Puccini. Richard Strauss wrote very prominently for winds in his orchestral pieces, and he did write concertos for horn, amongst other wind instruments. His father was a well-known horn player. But he did not write very much music for winds alone, and this is one of those pieces composed in the early years of the 20th century. I can't remember the precise long title. It's fanfare to the solemn entry processional of the something or other of St. John, but we usually just refer to it as a solemn entry. And originally scored for 15 trumpets, so our four are doing yeoman's duty. Actually, this is an addition for a brass with optional organ, and we're doing it without organ. We think it still sounds very beautiful, and hope you enjoy this solemn entry by Richard Strauss.
Thank you.
not much more can be said musically after that, but we would like to leave you with one final reflection. This is an arrangement of Amazing Grace by our very good friend, Philip Newman. And once again, it's been a supreme pleasure performing here on your Evensong concert series. We hope to see you again. Have a great evening. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.